Nebraska lawmakers are close to putting new safeguards in place for law enforcement. LB 226 creates the offense of assault with a bodily fluid against a public safety officer.
The bill has its critics, though, who argue it creates a stigma against those who are HIV positive. But law enforcement says the biohazard threat is real.
Bellevue police have all sorts of stories about the very unpleasant things that can happen in the back of police cruisers.
Explosive, diarrhea, and projectile vomiting.
And they have graphic photos of it all. Photos we'll spare you from seeing this morning. The threat from biohazards on the job is something the Bellevue Police Department takes very seriously. It relies on Cornhusker Auto Wash to clear out cruisers with cleaning agents you won't find in the average store.
We use basically disinfectants, very similar to what they might be using in emergency rooms for both blood and other things that might come in there.
Mark Fox takes precautions to keep his crew safe as well by making sure everyone wears protective gear like this. For Fox, as for police, biohazards are a big concern.
If the officer has an open cut or becomes in contact with those, it now requires us to get involved medically with the officer.
Since officers don't always know what's going to show up in the back seat, they keep a few extra things in the front. Things like hand sanitizer, facial masks, and protective gloves.
Those extra precautions help. Officer Mike Holmes says an incident requiring that protective gear happens at least twice a week.
We just try and stay away from that stuff as much as possible.
This special cleaning can take a cruiser out of service for up to a day. But Chief Stacy says it's a sacrifice that must be made to keep everyone, officers and citizens, safe.
It's not just like the old days where you just hose it out and go back to work. You can't do that anymore. There's really a lot of care we have to take.
Well, the bill making it a crime to assault a police officer with bodily fluids faces one more vote in the Nebraska legislature. Senator Mike Glor says he sponsored it when law enforcement went to him with concerns about the actions of jail inmates. He says 30% of Nebraska prisoners are infected with HIV, hepatitis B, or hepatitis C. A spokesperson for the Nebraska AIDS Project says the bill is recreating a stigma, suggesting casual contact by spitting or sharing a drink can transmit HIV.